Hello, my name is Niklas Hesslein. I'm research assistant at the Institute of Technical Logistics at the Hamburg University of Technology. In the next minutes, I would like to present the topic industrial indoor localization, improvement of logistics processes using location-based services. The results were obtained in a research project financed by the European Regional Development Fund. To begin with, I would like to explain why we have been working on the topic of location-based services and what challenges arise during the implementation. Afterwards, I will present a reference architecture for indoor localization called RAIL. This allows the implementation of location-based services in an adequate amount of time. In the following, I will present the location-based services, explain the benefits, and use these examples to show the necessity of a reference architecture at the end of the conclusion. A current problem, as you can see in this figure, is that each service requires various interfaces to different data sources. Most data sources do not have a standardized interface, so that a separate interface has to develop for each application. This leads to long development times. Furthermore, problems can occur with the integration into operational processes. Finally, the large number of interfaces significantly increases the maintenance effort of the services. Furthermore, an interface usually has to be programmed for a data exchange between two services. Thus, a provider of, for example, location-based services is not only required to develop the software, but also the hardware for localization. To solve these problems, it is advisable to introduce a reference architecture such as RAIL as a central data platform. RAIL is a digital twin which is both manufacturer and application independent. It standardizes the data and interface models. This results in only two interfaces in the application of location-based services. One for the storage of localization data, which we can find here, and one for its request, which we can find here. In addition to the many interfaces nowadays, object and its localization data, for example, are often stored in different databases. However, location-based services often require both information, so that, again, two database queries are necessary. RAIL, on the other hand, stores both information merged in one database. This offers the advantage that the development of services can be made more efficient. In addition, various data types, such as images, CAD models, or point clouds, can be stored in RAIL. These advantages of RAIL were incorporated into the development of our location-based services. As a first service, I would like to introduce the location-dependent allocation algorithm. In discussions with industry, we have discovered that warehouse management systems and narrow ASIL warehouses block ASILs as soon as a pick is to be made here. For example, as soon as the left picker has made his second pick, the ASIL with pick 3 is blocked for the right picker. He must either wait until the ASIL is free again or prefer later picks and other ASILs, which leads to detours. For this reason, we have developed an algorithm that opens the ASIL for a specific direction of travel as soon as sufficient safety distance between the pickers is ensured. For this purpose, geographical location data are considered instead of logical location data. So, for example, the white picker can already drive into the ASIL when the other one does the pick number 5. This logic is already executed when the order is placed. Here, it is estimated whether two pickers are likely to meet and whether there will be waiting times. If this is the case, the order is put on hold and another one is assigned without waiting time. If there is a waiting time during the picking process, either the picker must wait or the picking order is adjusted, depending on what has the shorter order throughput time. We have compared the effectiveness of location-based services with the algorithm of a warehouse management system used in practice by means of a simulation. It was found that the waiting time could be significantly reduced with an increasing number of pickers. This led to an increase in picking performance. The maximum increase is 13.2% with 10 pickers on 16 ASINs, which we can find here. Afterwards, the picking performance adjusts itself again because it's too much overlapping of pickers and ASINs, so that the waiting time can no longer be reduced sufficiently, which we can, for example, find here with 12 forklifts in this relation. The second location-based service accompanies the complete order picking process from order placement to autonomous storage of the full pallet. The service takes over the communication with the warehouse management system so that the employee does not have to confirm the order via handheld device. At the beginning, the LVS receives a clearance message from the picker. An order is then assigned to the picker as well as a semi-autonomous forklift. The forklift automatically removes an empty pallet, where the removal is recognized by the location data and the location-based service notifies the warehouse management system. The articles then picked. As soon as the employee is directly in front of the storage compartment, the pick is reported as made by the location-based service in the warehouse management system. This eliminates the need to scan the barcode. This small time saving scales over the amount of scan processes per day. As soon as no more picks are available, the forklift drives again autonomously to the defined transfer point of the pallet. The handover is again acknowledged in the warehouse management system by means of localization data. Our last location-based service recognizes digitally stored functional areas, so that when entering these areas, for example, a note about the permitted maximum speed can be displayed. For this purpose, both the functional surfaces and the localization data of the various systems are stored in Rail. In the figure, you can see a schematic representation of our experimental hall at the Institute. The gray areas represent different objects such as a pallet rack, which you can find here, or two forklifts, or one conveyor belt. The layout of the hall is transformed into a grid, where the size of the individual fields is freely selectable. This offers the advantage that the localization accuracy can be adapted to the respective application. Some points form restricted areas because they cannot be physically entered, like the stairs with the ID -1, which we can find here. Other areas can be stored digitally, such as the restricted area -3, which we can find here. This area was not previously stored as an object, but will also be in restricted area for each person. To define these points as restricted areas, they are assigned a negative ID. In the next step, speed limits can be created in the service. These are highlighted in yellow here. The decimal place indicates the percentage value of the actually allowed maximum speed. As soon as such a field is driven over, the employee is shown a note on the display. Finally, points of interest can be created. These are highlighted in blue and are assigned a positive ID. With this service, it is possible for employees to be navigated to the selected point of interest. This offers help for technicians, for example. When servicing forklifts, technicians no longer have to search for the vehicle in the hall, but can get there without detours. To sum up, proprietary localization systems lead to isolated solutions within a company. This can be avoided if a standard communication protocol has been established in the industry. Each of our location-based services uses multiple data sources, such as the warehouse management system, localization, or map information about the warehouse. To avoid having to implement different interfaces, Rail was used as a middleware. The centralized and joint data storage significantly reduced the development effort. For future research in this area, the industry should be increasingly involved in the development of such a reference architecture. This enables a high acceptance and improves the possibility to use it as a standard. In addition, the application side should be researched more intensively. The possibility to locate objects precisely offers new improvement potentials to redesign and optimize the operating process. Last but not least, the introduction of a kind of app store should be considered so that the introduction of location-based services in company can be made more efficient. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions or want more information about this topic, please do not hesitate to contact me. Please find my contact information on this slide.